We are back today with another episode of FDA Recalls. I'm a pharmacist. Welcome to Track MTM. Today's product is Odor Eaters is the brand name. The product description is Odor Eater Spray Products Only. For some reason, they always have problems with spray products because of the presence of benzene. Now, benzene is known to cause cancer. A while back, there were some sunscreen products that's in the sprayable canister. Those were recalled too. Perhaps that's another topic for another video. But under this category, it's under the cosmetics, deodorant, drugs, product type. The company name is Odor Eaters, owned by Blistech Incorporated. I actually use the Blistech lip balm. I love those products, but this pertains to the sprays only. Nationwide recalls a specific lots of Odor Eaters. Spray powders, stink stoppers due to benzene contamination. Recalling a total of 41 lots. That's a lot of lots. With benzene contamination in specific lots of these aerosol products. Classify as human carcinogen. Again, causing cancer. Exposure to benzene can occur in inhalation, consumed orally, absorbed through the skin, can also cause cancer, leukemia, and blood cancer of the bone marrow, and blood disorders, which can be life-threatening. To date, there hasn't been any kind of reports lately for, let's say, adverse events related to this recall. Maybe not yet, but who knows, down the road, people can have cancer. It's not like something that would typically develop in like 1 or 2 weeks. It takes a while. Odor Eaters spray products are used as antifungal and foot odor reducing agents packaged in aerosol cans. I will also show you guidance on where to find the lot code details on the can as well. You turn the canister like upside down there with the circly thing, typically it's at the bottom, right above the, I would say, the expiration dates. It's just a good habit. Whenever I see a product, turn it over, check the expiration date, and their lot number is somewhere around there. 41 lots though, that's a lot. Typically it's like, you know, a bad batch, it's like 1 to 5 maybe lots, that's a lot. 41, that's some serious benzene issues. Personally, I tend to avoid sprayable products or like anything in canister just because the formulations when it comes to spray stuff, like I say, contaminated with benzene. And throughout my career, I've seen a lot of this kind of stuff being contaminated with this human carcinogen. If there are other formulas out there, let's say lotions, cream, or stuff like that, I would use that. But sprayable canister, that's always dangerous. Consumers, distributors, and retailers with this recall should stop using or selling these specific products. Dispose of them appropriately, of course, and as always, you can always ask for a refund. If the stores refuse to do that for you, there's actually a number I will put in the description box that you can look at for more information. And if you have serious issues, you definitely need to seek medical attention. Overall, this is more of the quality issues with the supplier, as I mentioned earlier. And then it kind of domino effects to the company itself, and the company has to alert the consumers. Odor Eaters. I've actually never heard of this kind of products until now. That's also a reason why I do these series, so that I can get familiar with what other products that are out there that I might not use, but maybe you guys do, and vice versa. If you know of anything recalls and you're interested in a particular topic, let me know and I'll look into it. Leave me a comment below. We have the spray powder for athlete's foot. How free. The other Odor Eaters is stink stoppers for kids and teens. Odor killing dry spray. This can also work for long lasting sports scent. For adults, yeah, I can kind of understand, but for kids and teens, possibly causing cancer, That's a big issue. The FDA definitely should get involved. Well, that's it for today. I hope that was helpful. You guys let me know anything else you want to see. Have a fantastic day. Bye-bye.